Hey everybody, welcome to another dope episode of Song Theory. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Guys, oh my god, Kanye West finally dropped his new album, Jesus is King. So, very happy that he finally dropped it. This is a formal album review, and I want to go ahead and go through it because it literally just dropped today at 12 a.m. So I want to do an album review. I really like it. There's a lot of things I like about it, and there's some songs I like to just address and just put out there because I think, especially for those who haven't listened to it yet, I want to give you an idea of what you're going to listen to. And just let you know how it kind of is. And I, like I said, like this album a lot. But let's just go through it song by song, and I'm going to let you know exactly what to expect, okay? So the first song on the list is Every Hour. Now, this song is actually really good, and the way Every Hour works is that it literally is just the choir, okay? Just singing. Kanye West, I believe he probably composed this song, but I think that it's very atmospheric, and it does give you a good sense of what you're about to get into. I think that Every Hour is great because it kind of gives you this very soulful, very open, energetic feel. And it just feels good because you have to realize my background is in gospel music. I started in gospel music. That's where I got my start from, playing the instruments, drums, piano. So I know, I understand, I respect the choir, the church choir, okay? I get how powerful those melodies and those you know, the dynamics and the fantastic harmonies. He did it right. However, I don't think this should have been the first thing you came in with, to be honest, because, you know, first of all, it's only a few, it's actually, what, less than 2 minutes long, and really, honestly, the entire 2 minutes, it's just the choir just doing their thing. And so, like I said, a lot of people enjoyed this. I think it was nice. However, I think he should have chose a different song to start the album off with. Like I said, very atmospheric, very powerful, harmonies were on point. However, I do think he should have used a different song starting the album off. The next song on the list is, I'm not sure how to pronounce this, but Sela, not sure. But it starts off, I love this song because this actually, I think he did, this is one of his top songs, okay, that he did on this album. I have like a top three, but we'll go through that soon. Sela, or however you pronounce it, was really nice, and he came in with the intense lyrics. He was in there. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and give you an understanding of this album. This album is gospel. It is a truly straight up and down gospel album. No cursing, no talk of drug use, no talk of abuse. No, literally, it is probably the cleanest album. It is the cleanest album that Kanye West has ever made. And this is probably the cleanest, most concise gospel album I've ever heard from a hip-hop artist. Period. Okay? And in saying that, that means that the lyrics and the content of the songs are very focused on Jesus. There's very focused on the Holy Spirit. It's very focused on God. So, that is the majority of the lyrics. You're not going to hear a whole lot of different stuff. Okay? This is not Chance the Rapper's coloring book. You're not going to hear a whole lot of different. No, it's God, Jesus, faith, period. That's what this whole album is about. Now, I like this song because he did a very good job of kind of introducing it. I believe this should have been the first song on the album. He introduces the song. He kind of goes into it. He lets us know how he feels. Once again, talks about Jesus, talks about his relationship with God, talks about how, you know, he's essentially at the cusp of change. And I think that was great. It's very, very snappy, very good. The beat is fantastic. And, you know, overall, I really like this song in general. Now, another thing about this song is that, you know, in the first half of the song is him rapping, going at it. And when I talk about the beat, you have to realize, I'm a musician, so I can hear the rhythm in the song without there being an actual beat. You know, so in the first half of the song, there really actually is just organ, church organ. And as he's going through it, you hear the chords changing, you know, 1-3-5 or whatever the progression is, and he's going through it, and the lyrics are powerful. These are very powerful lyrics for a man who's gone through kind of his journey, and I love it, you know. And then once you kind of get to the other half of the song, that's when the choir comes back in, and they're just hitting their hallelujahs, hitting those notes, hitting those melodies, and man, this song is very powerful. This is the song that should have been first on the album, hands down. But it's also in my top three of my favorite songs of the album, Jesus is King. So the next song is Follow God. Now, Follow God's good. I like the beat. The beat's very pretty much, it's a hip hop beat. I mean, you're getting exactly what you're getting. It's a hip hop beat. Now, you do have a man singing on it, and it sounds like an old gospel song, but I can't quite put my ear on it. But you do have, you know, it doesn't sound like Kanye West. However, he's credited on this song. No one else is. But whoever's rapping on here doesn't sound like Kanye for some reason. I don't know why. But it's actually a very generic song. It's very plain. It doesn't get not a whole lot of chorus, not a whole lot of gospel inspiration, except for that gentleman who's in the back singing and for a little bit of church organ. Other than that, I honestly don't even really feel like this song fit with the rest of this album. I would go as far to say it, I would leave this song out of the album. I think that as we go through the rest of it, you'll kind of understand what I mean by the theme. And of course, the lyrics matched up with the theme, you know, talking about following God, talking about being a better person, talking about, you know, all the darkness in the world. Yes. Okay, great. But the vibe of this song, the feeling of this song, the energy in this song does not match the rest of the album. So personally, I would go as far to say I would cut this out. I would put that to the side for another day. And I personally think it would probably be best as a singular project and not a part of Jesus is King. Okay, so the next song is called Closed on Sunday. Now, if you didn't like Chick-fil-A before, you will not like Chick-fil-A now. Because this song, I will go as far to say, is an endorsement and sponsored by Chick-fil-A. Closed on Sunday is, you know, he's going through the song talking about the issues of life, talking about what's going on and how we need to get our families together and how we need to be closed off on Sunday so that we can praise God and be a part of that journey. And be together on Sunday to go to church. But then, you know, he also starts talking about, you know, clothes on Sunday, clothes like Chick-fil-A. And so what you begin to realize is, you know, Chick-fil-A seems to be a big inspiration to him, apparently. And so clothes on Sunday, like I said, if you don't like Chick-fil-A, you won't like Chick-fil-A after this song plays. But this song is very solemn. I do like it because it's solemn. It is Kanye going through the lyrics. He's being very plain, and he has a great understanding of what the message is. And I think that's what I like about this album the most, because there's a very concise message throughout the whole album. And that's the beauty of gospel albums in general. If you have not listened to gospel music in your lifetime, or you don't really mess with it that much, I guarantee you to start off with Fred Hammond, start off with Kirk Franklin, start off with John P. Key. These are great artists in the gospel music community. I guarantee you, you'll listen to it, you'll love them. And the reason is because they're very concise and their albums, their songs are very simple to understand or to remember. And I think Kanye West learned a lot from these gentlemen because if anyone is the biggest inspiration to him in the world that Kanye West is in, it would be Kirk Franklin. So I think that whatever he's doing right now is a culmination of everything he learned from all those great artists, and he's putting it to great use. I would say that. He's putting it to great use. And I think this song really does fit well with the album, and I do appreciate its presence on the project. All right, so the next song we're talking about is On God. I don't like this song. I don't like the vibe. I don't like the style of it. It has a really weird high-pitched synth that kind of goes throughout and sustains itself throughout the song. I don't like the flow of the lyrics. I think the lyrics are okay for what the song is about, but I just not feeling it. Once again, I try to make it very clear that the song content is fine. What they're talking about, On God, is about being, you know, righteous, is about being together with your family, it's about knowing who you are. That's cool, but this song just does not match the tonal value of this album. It just doesn't, I don't really like it, you know. And this is basically on it's like a separate list, you know. You have your top three, and then I have the songs that could have been left out. And this is definitely one of those songs you could have left out, you know, between On God and Follow God is one of the two of the songs I would definitely leave out. But other than that, it's a pretty good song. I just don't think it's good for this project. Anyway, guys, the next song we're going to be talking about is Everything We Need. Kanye West, Ty Dolla $ign, and Aunt Clemens. Very good combo. I like the trio. Very nice. I think Kanye's lyrics are fantastic on this song. And the pre-chorus and the chorus, I believe, have the harmonies that they're singing. And the bass is not very heavy. You know, it's actually a very quiet song. And Jesus he has everything we need. This is exactly what you think the song is about. But it's the way they execute it. I really do appreciate it. And I think that Kanye West has been working hard on making sure that these songs don't sound the same. And they, so far they don't. But what I think as well is that he's making sure that the spirit of the song stays the same and stays consistent throughout the project. And so far he's doing a good job of that. All right, the next song, and most probably one of the most controversial songs, is Water. Ant Clemons and Kanye West at it again. Good song. However, you have this jazz kind of like R&B guitar kind of going throughout it. I think it's good, but right back to the whole synth thing again. Now, I know Kanye West is known for the synth, especially on his voice, especially with the auto-tune. But I think it could have went without that. I think it would have been fine if it was just his natural voice. Also, I think that this song, Water, is good. I just think, once again, that this might have been one of those other songs I would have left off the album. The reason why I say also this is controversial is because this was one of the songs that Kanye had mentioned to us that he was working on, the one that he said was holding the album up. So to me, in my opinion, it's a little disappointing to hear that the song that you were keeping the album from us because of, it kind of ended up being a wash. And no pun intended, the song's called Water, but the song didn't end up being as good as I thought it would be because it was the reason why they held up the album in the first place. One of the reasons. And so, once again, Ant Clemons did well, so did Kanye. The vibe of the song, I think, was good, but I'm not sure if that guitar and that kind of softness of the song was kind of matching the album's feel. Now, once again, I say this because, remember, the very first song was the powerful chorus, knocking you out of your seat, knocking you into the next week. Like, you hear it, you feel it. Why would you have that be the start of the album if some of the rest of the songs are going to be slow, kind of drolling, kind of, you know, I don't like that. If you're going to give us a taste of it, give us a good taste of it. Which, like I said, Sila would have been a great taste, would have been a great intro to the album, but it wasn't. So as we go into it, songs like Water, not really matching up for me. The next song we're talking about is God Is. God is pretty good. I think this is the most intimate song on the album because it's just Kanye back at it with his, with his auto-tune voice. However, the song itself is very good. I like the drums. It's very bright. It's a very bright song, you know, and it sounds really good with the background chorus as well. And it's back with some of that chorus again. And I'm like, give us more of that chorus. Like, don't... He gave us some of the chorus in the beginning. I think he should have been consistent with that chorus. I want to hear more of that chorus, okay? When I listen and look at Sunday Mornings with Kanye West, I'm listening for that chorus. You know what I'm saying? Where they at? So I just kind of wish that on these songs, you know, it was a little bit more of that. And so I do appreciate what they tried to do on the song. Like I said, I think it's more intimate. And I think it's a good addition to the album. I would keep it. I think it's good. However, I do wish that, you know, they gave us a little bit more of that chorus, a little bit more of it. But other than that, God is a good song. All right. So the next song we're talking about is Hands On. Hands On, one of my favorite songs on the album. Fred Hammond actually was on it. Very good. Kanye West and Fred Hammond make a great combination. The subject matter in this song is actually a little different from the rest of the album. The subject matter here is not just talking about Jesus and God. However, he's talking about the judgment that he faces for going into and foraying into gospel music. And Fred Hammond also, with his background vocals into the chorus, is very good. I think that Fred Hammond is a great addition to this album, and I think he was an even better addition to the song. It's actually kind of a dark song, and it's one of those gospel songs that kind of deal with the doubt, and it deals with the pain of being a Christian, less than just being a Christian in general. And I think that he did a very good job. And he was emboldened to make that part. He was emboldened to say what he needed to say. And I think the lyrics were actually above the music itself. The lyrics were fantastic. And if they used any other music on top of it, I think it would have sounded really good. The music did play a role. I think I liked it a lot. It was very, like I said, solemn, grave, you know, very deep. The synthesizer was kind of stretching itself out. You know, you were kind of being carried by the song into the next verse. And I did like that, because what it made me feel like was I was kind of on a journey with this song. And that's why I say it was very intimate. And he was coming from a very genuine place. So Fred Hammond, Kanye West did a very good job on Hands On, and I think that I did appreciate that. The next song is called Use This Gospel. Now, Use This Gospel is on the top three for a very, very specific reason. You have Kanye West, Kenny G, and Clips. And I think that's how you pronounce his name. But with those three, this trio is amazing. The music is very simple. Okay, it's actually not a whole lot going on, and I like the way they keep it simple. It makes the song kind of, you know, it makes it a little bit more visceral when you don't put a whole lot of 808s, don't put a whole lot of bass, don't put a whole lot of high ends. Just leave it the way it is, you know. It was almost like they were just strumming one string of the guitar and just hitting some synth, and that's basically it, right? They kind of backed off. But I really like this song because they did a great job of explaining the message, putting it out there, very powerful. The way they delivered the gospel in this song was very good. And I think that Kenny G, out of all people, first of all, I never thought he'd do a hip-hop album. I never thought he'd do a gospel album. And I never thought I'd hear Kanye West and Kenny G on the same song. So to go as far to say that Kenny G at the end carried the rest of the melody for about 8 to 16 bars, it was fantastic. And you don't hear Kenny G often. If you don't know who Kenny G is, he is a alto saxophone player. Fantastic. You'll probably hear more of him during Christmas time, but he's fantastic. And Clips, I believe that's his name, awesome rapper. I would suggest you go look him up. But this would be one of the top three songs on the album, and I don't think anyone disagrees with that, to be totally honest. This song was fantastic. And the final song, the namesake of the album, the last hurrah, the outro, Jesus Is King. I have a huge issue with this one because it is unfulfilling. If you're going to do an outro, you want to make sure that outro hits. You want to make sure that it smacks you into next week. You want to make sure it brings people back to the album and go, you know what? I didn't have enough of that. I want more. Give me more. No, this song was not only the namesake of the album, okay? It was 49 seconds long. 49 seconds. Unacceptable. Kanye, come on, brother. Come on, not 49 seconds. Now, it upsets me because, you know, I'm not trying to say it was a bad 49 seconds. Thought it was fine. I'm just like, if it's an outro, give us something more than that, man. Give us an actual song. You know, it almost makes me feel like this album was a little rushed. And it sounds stupid because he kept it from us for so long, but when you do stuff like that, you know, 49 seconds, sure, it might be an artistic decision, but it just seems lazy. All the rest of the songs were of good length, of good quality. Why did this have to be 49 seconds? It just seemed like it just didn't seem right to me. It felt a little cheap. And maybe, you know, obviously that's my opinion. Everyone, tell me what you think in the comments. How did you like Jesus Is King? How did you like the album? You know, just to sum it all up, you know, my top three were Use This Gospel, Hands On, Sela were probably the top three. Okay? And now the songs I think I would have left off the list for sure is Follow God, On God, Water. You know, I would have left those off the list. And I think Jesus Is King. I think that leaving that on the list is fine. I would have left that on the project. However, I would have made that a longer song. Give me 2 minutes. Give me 3 minutes. Give me something. That ain't enough. You know, give me a full song that'll last me for the rest of the day, because I will be like, I want to go back home and listen to the rest of it. Overall, if I gave this album a total grade, I would say for sure, I would give it a pretty much a 9 out of 10. I think this album was very, very well done, very well spoken. It was just a really good album, and I think that for those who have not listened to gospel very often, I think Kanye West is introducing people to a whole new genre. And I think it's really good that Kanye West himself has gotten out of that darkness that he was in. Remember, guys, he made a song once called, what was it called? I Had a Dream That I Killed You or something. Like, this guy was going through a lot. But it's good to hear that he's kind of working all that out, and this album was just, it was a faith walk. Because he didn't know how this album would do. We still don't know how it'll do. But so far, we all like it, and I know for sure I definitely like it. So if you liked it and you watched it, tell me below. How did you feel about it? Did you like the album? What did you think? What were your top three? What were your leave-off lists? What do you give it, you know, out of 10? What do you give it, you know, as a letter grade? How do you feel about the album? Because like I said, I pretty much give it one of the highest marks I can give it. It was a great album, great project. Some things could have been left off, but other than that, I thought it was really good. So everyone, thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, and there'll be more album reviews, obviously, as they come out, and more content coming to the channel. I thank you all so much for watching this, and I hope you all have a great day and a better tomorrow. God bless. I'll see you all later.